Welcome, AGTV viewers. We thank you so much for joining us today. Today, we have a treat for you. We have Donnie Carter of Carter Ministries joining us. He is an anointed singer, so stay tuned.
Uplifting, refreshing, life-changing. It's Amazing Grace TV.
Donnie, thank you so much for joining us today. Taking time out of your busy schedule to be here with AGTV. Thank you again
for coming. Having me.
I want to first ask you, what brought you to, and I know I want to know, but I know our viewers want to know as well, what brought you to your saving knowledge of Jesus Christ? What made you the Lord of your life?
Well, I look back about probably 8 years ago, and laying on a gurney in a hospital, going through trials and tribulations, realized that I had to give my life to Christ. Either that or just go ahead and die. But, you know, I wasn't going to allow myself to do that. My mom had taught me better than that going through church as a little kid. That day, I gave my life to Christ. And I told him, from here on in, I'm done. I can't do anything. I'm finished. I'm letting you take over. And by the glory of God, glory be to God, he took over, and here I am today.
What age was that?
Oh, I was probably, I will say probably about 45, 46 years old.
Wow. Yeah. Okay. Mm-hmm. So can you give me a little bit of your background?
I was the son of Roy Carter and Evelyn Bradford out of Alexandria, Virginia. I was born in Alexandria Hospital. Fortunately, as I was a little child, I was taken in by the social services, and I was in a lot of foster homes. Went through that for probably 5 or 6 years before I was placed in a home, an actual home. When I was 5 years old in Amosville, Virginia. I probably was in like maybe 15 different homes.
15?
Yeah, between the ages of 1 to 5.
So in coming from those different homes or going through those different homes, I'm sure you experienced, or I shouldn't say I'm sure, did you experience maybe any depression during those times, or was it like, how was it? You know, was it?
At the time, at that time, well, once I grew up and knew what was really going on, I really didn't have any depressions. Actually, it was a learning experience for me because I got to live in different cultures, different, 1 minute I'd be here, I'd be there. So it gave me a chance to learn to adapt to what life brings to you.
Okay, and the reason why I say depression, I've had different other persons that I've talked with in this journey, and they've said that one of the major things that they've encountered going from home to home or place to place is depression. And so that's one of the things that I've wanted to ask you, and hearing that wasn't the case with you. Christ was with you.
Christ was with, like I said, when I finally got placed in a home in Amosville, I had a very Christ-like basis, you know, in the home. My mom and dad went to church every Sunday. They, you know, they were very into what was going on at our church. And as a little kid, I went, you know, with my mom, and that today, to this day, I will say, stayed with me throughout my, you know, my life coming from a teenager into my adulthood. I'm not saying that my life was led strictly, you know, through Christ at that time, mm-hmm. but that was embedded in me. And eventually that day I was laying on that gurney, it all came back. All that experience that I had in church and what I did in church back in the in those days came back to bring me where I needed to be. So that was a blessing.
So tell me about your calling, the other gifts that the Lord has created within you.
Well, I feel that God has created in me the gifts of bringing people closer to Christ, bringing out, letting go. Mm-hmm. Of I've gone into churches and you see people, they're, as they say, rocks, you know. But He has installed in me a way of letting people feel comfortable, free, letting their hair down, which gives them the opportunity to worship, which brings the passion of Christ. I want to bring people closer to Christ.
Okay.
And somehow He's installed in me that I can go and I can capture people's attention and capture them for that moment that will allow God to come into them and hear the word that God has that He brings through me.
So and through ministry?
Through ministry, through word, through song. I believe that's what God has installed in me to do.
And so, okay, speaking of singing, mm-hmm. which you do very well, mm-hmm. very anointed singer.
Thank you.
Would you mind at this point singing a song for us?
Sure. No problem.
And which song would you? I'll let you pick.
Okay, well, what I do is I go and I listen at the Sunday morning worship, praise and worship, and I just hear all the anointed singers that are out there, and I go and I get the track, you know, the accompaniment to them. And those songs, I think, I go out and I praise and worship with those tracks. Some of the artists that I like are Smokey Norfolk, I Need You Now, B.B. Winan, C.C. Winan, just Donnie McClurkin, all those singers. I just love their music, and I think they have a great anointment to them. So what I'll sing tonight is one by Smokey Norfolk. I love that song. I think it's just a powerful, powerful song. I Need You Now.
Ooh, and how fitting that
amen.
Is.
Amen.
So AGTV viewers, join us now as we listening to the anointed singing of Donnie Carter.
Not a second of another minute, not an hour of a night and day, but at this moment with my arms outstretched, you need you right away.